Welcome to the second part of this series, where I show how a violin is built. Today I'm going to prepare the ribs and the corner blocks, and I'm going to glue the first part of the ribs in the C parts of the instrument. First, I have to bring the ribs in the thickness they have to be. At this moment, the ribs are 1.8 millimeters, 1.7, and they have to be 1.2, so I just need to clean them almost and then they will be ready. And I will do that using the paper sander. I can also do that with a plane, but because of the bird eye effect in the wood, I expect that it will break. That's why I will do it on the machine and not by hand. Okay, the ribs are now at the thickness they have to be. They are 1/10 of a millimeter thicker, but that's okay because later on I will have to clean them again before varnishing the instrument. So I will let them like that. Now I'm going to start working on the corner blocks. The first stage is to make a flat surface at the end of the corners, and then I will start working on the inner part of the four corners. Now the corner blocks are ready, and I'm going to bend the ribs. I have three pieces. I'm going to use one piece for the two C parts, and the other two pieces are going to be used for the upper and the lower parts. I'm going to use my bending iron to bend the ribs. It's already on and it's hot, and when I say hot, I mean really hot. To start with, I have to cut one of the pieces in two, so I can use one for left and one for the right part. Now the two pieces are ready. Because they are a bit too high, I'm going to cut a piece off, because then it's easier to bend them. I am about to start bending the ribs. The wood is ready, the iron is hot. I have some water here and a sponge. I'm going to wet the ribs for three different reasons. The first of all is because when wood becomes wet, it's more elastic, so the fibers bend easily. The second one is that the water boils and goes through the wood, so it helps the wood to become warmer at both sides. And the last reason is because, of course, the iron is very hot and I don't want to burn them, because then they will make dark brown or maybe black signs. The water helps it to become very hot, but not to burn. The bending is a very tricky procedure. It is very easy to break the ribs, they are only 1.2 millimeters thick. And you want to have a very nice going curve, which follows the curve of the C parts. And I don't have to bend them a lot of times back and forth, because then I will get kind of a wave instead of a nice line. That's it. Let's go, let's see how it goes. This part is ready, so now I can go to this part, of course, turn it upside down, and then bend the other side exactly in the same way. Now the other part is also ready. I can glue them, only putting glue here, between the block and the rib. This part doesn't have to be glued, because the form has to go out. But before I start gluing, I have to do something else. Here I have a very big piece of sandpaper, which is glued on a piece of wood, which is totally flat. And I have to make the surface of the blocks flat from the side of the top, and then the same at the other side of the back side. But in the second part, I have also to make the blocks a bit smaller on the top and bigger at the bottom, because a violin is not a rectangular box, but it goes to a bit smaller to the top. So I will start with a part of the top. Okay, now the top part is ready. I can turn it around and go to the back side. Now I have to be careful to take some more wood off from the top side where the scroll is going to be, a bit less on the underside. And of course I'm going to measure this, because I want to reach certain measurements. To glue the ribs on the blocks, I will do it one by one, and I will keep the other part fastened on its position, so I have a reference and it doesn't move. So I am sure that I will put it again exactly on the same place as it has to be. Now they are both glued on their place, It has to stay like that until tomorrow at least. That's it for this time. Next time I will make the upper and lower parts of the ribs and also glue the linings on their place. If you have any questions, feel free to comment below. Don't forget to share the video so also other people can see how their instrument is made. And I will see you next time again. Bye bye!